article in the Washington Post. It's by a Marine Captain, Timothy Kudo. But unfortunately, he's not just a Marine Captain. He's a graduate student at New York University, where his article will be regarded as holy writ. "I Killed People in Afghanistan, Was I Right or Wrong?" by Timothy Kudo. "When I joined the Marine Corps, I knew I would kill people. I was trained to do it in a number of ways, from pulling a trigger to ordering a bomb strike to beating someone to death with a rock. As I got closer to deploying to war in 2009, my lethal abilities were refined, but my ethical understanding of killing was not. I held two seemingly contradictory beliefs. Killing is always wrong, but in war it is necessary. How could something be both immoral and necessary?" Well, this is, I will read more. This is what happens at universities. As I told you, you get morally confused. Now, it's not that they talk in great subtleties that outside the university world people are not used to engaging in. No. They are morally confused at the university, and they pass on their moral confusion and their broken moral compasses to students. "I held two seemingly contradictory beliefs. Killing is always wrong, but in war it is necessary." Whoever said killing is always wrong? Where did he get that from? "Only pacifists believe killing is always wrong, and pacifism is an immoral doctrine. It would enable evil to engulf the earth." So his very premise is foolish. Killing is always wrong, but in war it is necessary. Who said killing is always wrong? Major Kudo, now a graduate student at NYU. "I didn't have time to resolve this question before deploying, and in the first few months I fell right into killing without thinking twice. We were simply too busy to worry about the morality of war. We were simply too busy to worry about the morality of what we were doing." All right. "Many veterans are unable to reconcile such actions in war," it tells about ordering killings, "with the biblical commandment, thou shalt not kill." You would think that if a guy is going to write for the Washington Post and considers himself serious enough a thinker to be published in the Washington Post, he would know that that's a wrong translation. How many times does it need to be said? And by the way, now increasingly translations are accurate. They say, thou shalt not murder. I know biblical Hebrew very well. I've taught the Bible all of my life from the Hebrew, the Old Testament. There are two words in Hebrew in the Bible for killing. Harog and Ratzoch. I'm giving you the three-letter root, as said in Hebrew. Laharog is to kill. Lirtzoach is to murder. So that's it. And the Ten Commandments is Lo Tirtzach. Do not murder. If it said, Lo taharog, do not kill, we couldn't kill animals. We'd have to be vegetarian. We couldn't kill in self-defense. He must think the Bible is stupid to say that killing is always wrong. The Bible would be stupid, would be morally as foolish as NYU, if it were to say killing is always wrong. But it doesn't. So his entire premise is wrong. It's morally wrong, it's factually wrong. But it doesn't matter to the Washington Post, certainly. It doesn't matter to NYU, and it doesn't matter to the author. I'm talking to you about a member of the Marine Corps, a captain, Timothy Kudo, who's now a graduate student at New York University, where, as in most universities, his moral IQ is being lowered. I mean that literally. I actually do, as you know, I do believe that if you take your professor seriously at most universities, you will leave morally confused at best and with morally bad ideas at worst. So here is this man now thinking he was in Afghanistan. I don't know. It says killing is always wrong, but in war it is necessary. How could something be both immoral and necessary? He makes a premise that has no moral or logical or biblical basis, that killing is always wrong. If the government raised taxation to 99% and people cheated on taxes, would you think that they were wrong?
I would think they were perfectly justified.
Let me explain something. This is very, very, very important, and I appreciate your call immensely, Alejandro. I appreciate that he's trying to work it through also. Essentially, no act is always wrong. That is why people who believe in moral absolutes, as I do, must understand that you always ask about the context to know whether the act is right or wrong. Those of us who think that on rare occasions waterboarding is moral, we will have to say that to protect vast numbers of innocents from violent death, we will waterboard an individual to find out where the bomber is. If you don't believe in waterboarding ever, then you have to confront the consequences of your moral decision. You know for a fact that this person is not a person you suspect. You know for a fact this person knows who is poisoning the water supply of a city. Do you waterboard him, or do you have on your shoulders the problem of allowing a million innocents to die because you won't waterboard one? So drop the word always, folks. There is no act that is always wrong. Is intercourse wrong or right? It depends on the context. If the woman is unwilling, then it's a rape. That's why we have one word says make love and the other word says rape for the identical act, because context determines the morality of an act. So killing isn't always wrong. And nobody ever claimed it was. You have to go to college or graduate school to start thinking that confusedly. This is a perfect example of it. This article is up, incidentally, at DennisPrager.com by this Marine captain who will invite on the show. Many veterans, he continues, and I'll take more of your calls on this, many veterans are unable to reconcile such actions in war with the biblical commandment, thou shalt not kill. So to any veteran listening who did kill the enemy in Afghanistan, may I tell you that the man doesn't know what he's writing. Literally doesn't know what he's writing. And didn't even inquire before writing the piece to find out what he's writing. It says, thou shalt not murder, not thou shalt not kill. Then he continues, when they come home from an environment where killing is not only accepted, but is a metric of success, the transition to one where killing is wrong can be incomprehensible. Really? So all the veterans who came home from World War II were in moral confusion because they transited from, they made the transition from a place where killing is a metric of success to one where killing is wrong and it can be incomprehensible. If you go to NYU, it is incomprehensible. That's exactly what I believe is the case here. Whatever he's paying, he should get his money back. We should get our money back to the extent that with taxpayers have helped with the loans. The moral idiots who teach him. Really? Moral confusion? I'd like to ask the captain, those who killed Nazis in World War II, should they have come home morally confused? I've been reading to you from this truly foolish piece by a graduate student at New York University. who was a Marine captain, and he's morally confused. He says he's morally confused, but he doesn't realize how morally confused he is. When they come home talking about veterans from an environment where killing is not only accepted but is a metric of success, the transition to one where killing is wrong can be incomprehensible. I wonder if there were 50 veterans of World War II who found it incomprehensible that it was a good thing to shoot at the Japanese soldiers and a good thing to shoot at Nazi soldiers, but it's not a good thing to shoot at people back home. You think there were 50 people who were confused? We truly do live in the age of stupidity. I would put this up, and I don't blame the man. I blame the man for not being diligent in his research to know that the Ten Commandments doesn't say thou shalt not kill. It says thou shalt not murder. But he's just a product of our time, and now of graduate school at New York University. Wow, I don't understand. It was okay to kill terrorists in Afghanistan and the Taliban who throw acid in the faces of girls who go to school, but it's not okay to kill my neighbor back here in Michigan? Man, I just can't comprehend that, man. You wrinkle my brain. That wrinkles my brain. That's what he's saying about veterans. I mean, veterans ought to write in and say, who the hell is this guy talking on behalf of? He's talking on behalf of NYU, not veterans. This is the crap you learn. The moral idiocy that you get PhDs in. The number of people who have a PhD in moral idiocy is very high. They just do different theses on the same subject of moral confusion. Then he goes on, after writing, everything is based on nonsense. Then this incongruity can have devastating effects. After more than 10 years of war, the military has lost more active duty members last year to suicide than to enemy fire. Well, among other things, it shows how few have been killed, thank God, by enemy fire. But is that the reason? Because they just couldn't comprehend how it is that they could kill in Afghanistan, but they can't kill in New Jersey? Whoa, that's a big leap there, Major Kudo. While I don't know why individual veterans resort to suicide, after just saying that it's because of the moral confusion over killing. While I don't know, this is what I'm trying to tell you every single day, the lack of reason-based thinking on the left. While I don't know why individual veterans resort to suicide, I can say that the ethical damage of war may be worse than the physical injuries we sustain. Really? This is something new. The ethical damage of war? Man, we elected the biggest killer of all, president, in Dwight Eisenhower. It's so obnoxious. I wish veterans were aware of this piece. To properly wage war, you have to recalibrate your moral compass. No, you don't at all. Killing murderers, killing terrorists, is a good deed. It's good, Major Kudo. It's good. Your compass is broken. You need to recalibrate. Not us. We can tell the difference between killing somebody back home in Ohio and killing a Taliban. We have such a compass, Major Kudo. So we do not need recalibration. NYU needs recalibration, sir. That's why we started Prager University. For moral recalibration after college. You are listening to the Dennis Prager Show. It's not possible to overstate. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to say this. It's not possible to overstate how stupid the age in which we live in is. And it's due to secularism, colleges, and television. The terrible trinity that has reduced the intellect, the wisdom, and the moral compass of Americans. They're in tandem. One reinforces the other. secularism in the university in particular, a lot of secular, wonderful people don't deliberately mishear me. And there are a lot of religious jerks. Okay, we all know that. It has nothing to do with what I'm talking about. Nothing. It has to do with thinking. At NYU, they think this article is brilliant. The article is on such a low intellectual level, it is painful for me to say this because I don't insult people. I'm not insulting the man. He may be a wonderful man, but the article is just silly. They understood what they were saying when they said kill. They understood it meant murder. They understood there's legitimate killing, moral killing. Folks, it drives me crazy when people don't use common sense. The very same book, Exodus, where you find there were two versions of the Ten Commandments. They're only different essentially in the Sabbath commandment, in giving the reason for the Sabbath. And otherwise, they're basically the same in Deuteronomy and in Exodus. In Deuteronomy, it's Moses recounting it. And the very same book that has the Ten Commandments, Exodus, also has all these capital offenses, right? You put to death murderers. So how could killing be always wrong? You're allowed to go to war if it's a moral war. So who would think that that commandment bans all killing? Murder is immoral killing. Rape is immoral intercourse. There's moral intercourse and immoral intercourse. Saying rape is wrong, it would be as if one were to translate thou shalt not rape as thou shalt not have intercourse. Intercourse involves rape. Murder involves killing, but not all killing is murder, and not all intercourse is rape, except for a few feminists who held that all intercourse is rape. But I can't comment on that. Terry in Oklahoma City, Dennis Prager, hi.
Hello, Dennis. I'm a big fan. I'm glad I got through.
Thank you.
My main point was the way I always understood from, you know, a young child reading the Bible was that, did I just forget what I was going to say?
If you did, I'll put you on hold and come back to you.
No,
it's happened before. Okay.
It's not what you do, it's how you do it, you know, which is a very simplistic way of boiling down what you're talking about here.
Not how, why.
Exactly.
Yes.
But, I mean, the way I thought of it was just how you do it. You know, so, you know, you kill somebody because you want to kill them. It's murder. You kill somebody because they're trying to kill you. It's not murder.
Well, that's right. That's exactly right. Yes. In other words, what you knew as a kid in Oklahoma, I presume, is not known at NYU. Now, am I generalizing? Of course I'm generalizing. If you can't generalize, you there's something wrong with your mind because it means you don't see patterns. There are patterns between Oklahoma upbringings and NYU grad students, okay? There are patterns of different moral clarity and thinking. Killing is always wrong. For your information, I deal with that issue at length, at the clearest I have ever explained it in my book, Still the Best Hope, Why the World Needs American Values to Triumph. And in it, in explaining Judeo-Christian values, I explain why you must believe in moral absolutes, but it doesn't mean any act is always wrong. No act in and of itself is always wrong. There are certain things, there are circumstances determine. Otherwise, it would say thou shalt not kill, and it says thou shalt not murder, as I have said for all these years. But obviously the Marine